Welcome, ladies and gentlemen, to Castile Generations episode 13. And as always, me, the owner and the CEO of Castile Wrestling, Matt Rush, and we're here live in Raleigh, North Carolina for this very exciting edition of Castile Generations Cuts tonight in the main event. The Castile Deathweight Champion, Victor Escobar, is defending his Deathweight title in an open challenge. Honestly, I can't wait to see who will challenge him for the title. But we are kicking off tonight with women's tag team action. As introducing first, this 2/3 of the human anomaly. On your right, Evelyn Masters. And Rocks on your left, Roxy Apocalypse. Usually when you see these two, the third member, Tabitha Blackheart, you would usually be with them. But she is somewhat pursuing a single career on Generations right now. I mean, on Breed. My bad. My mistake, folks. So these two are currently representing the Human Anomaly. So these two are looking to gain some tag team. It's been a while since we've seen them. So they are looking to make a name for themselves in the tag team division. But as much as I like these two, I like Roxy, I like Evelyn, you know, but these, my own flesh and blood, these three, I hate most of all, because last time we seen my sisters, they beat our women's tag team champions, Crystal and Solas, 2/4 of the carnival by count out the first time ever, really, in cash style. We have had a count out. We installed the 20 count in cash style for a reason. But for the first time ever, because of these three, they somehow managed to get a count out victory. I don't know how, but they somehow did. You can tell, folks, I am very, very upset by this. And honestly, I wish I could say that there's nothing really I can say. There's nothing really, like, Crazy and Zora, like, they beat the tag champ, so they're first in line for the shot at the titles, and which more than likely it's going to happen at New Revolution. So it just ticks me off, people. It just frustrates me a little bit. I'm sorry. It's just crazy how things work out. It's just crazy. But let's get this matchup on their way here. Evelyn and Zora starting off the matchup. And already Zora with a snap suplex. Oh, missed a stump though. Ooh, missed a slap. But oh, with her probably a double leg, but ooh, drop toe into the middle ropes. Now, the last time Evelyn really came into problems was during the early stages of season 2 with her rivalry with Robin Vane, where that air match at Catch Anniversary was one of the most craziest, wildest last women's standing matches I've ever seen in my life. But now that she brought in her girls in the Human Anomaly, they're looking to make some waves in the tag division. I mean, they've had opportunities. I mean, they won a 6-woman tag team match. They was a part of the Gauntlet match to crown the first ever women's tag team champion. So they have had some good moments here in Castile, but they just haven't had much. But now, ooh! Zora's in complete control of Evelyn. And it's early going in this matchup. But Evelyn, turn the tides, taxing Roxy. Now, wait a minute. Suplex Doomsday device, god damn. Now that was crazy. But ooh, Zora will jawbreaker. Now, wait a minute. What's Zora doing? Snapmare takedown, making sure that the bigger opponent in Roxy, the glowing murder mohawk herself, stays in line. But Roxy is in control, stomped to the abdomen. Jesus Christ. As now, sailing into the corner, big clothesline. If you're wondering why Rossi's hair glows so much, honestly, it's all that shit she uses to make it stay up that way. And oh my god! What a suplex body slam there by Roxy. And now hit her with the right hand. Ooh! As now Roxy, what she's looking for here, camo clutch applied. Mr. E. Bayless, our referee here for ooh! Roxy hit the bottom rope kind of hard there, so it caught me off guard, but ooh, sidestep. Into the Saheel suplex onto the murder mohawk. Let's now drag her away from the corner. Now wait a minute, let's see what we're looking for here. Going to the arm of Roxy, but Roxy now fighting back. And now wait a minute, ooh, reversal by Zora, sending Roxy over the top rope onto the apron. And now, oh my god, belly to belly suplex, what the fuck? Here's the thing about Zora, she's, ooh, big lariat. Here's the thing about Zora that I forgot, oh my god, there's Eva. I can't even get Santa's out with something happening out. Oh my god! Zora just dropped Roxy on her damn neck with that German suplex. And here come Miss Crazier. Oh my god. A triangle choke. What the fuck? I'm seeing shit from my sisters that I have never seen before in my life. They're usually the ones who bring out glass bottles and shove it up, destroy over people's heads or shove it up their ass. Trust me, I've seen some shit, but, ooh. I was about to say pin tap there by Kizzy, but now Roxy, oh my god, with Roxy with a big boot, trying to keep the pressure on, as now Fireman's carry into the Samoan drop. And now Roxy thinking for the next move, but wait a minute, ooh, jawbreaker by Kizzy, and now Luke dead press, and now Ray, and now the rights. That's the thing that my sisters, they want to do. They want you to brawl with them. They will want you to go toe-to-toe with them. And Roxy Amlin, they've been showing that when they get a chance. Like right now, Roxy's in complete control of the match. A big lariat in the corner. And now, oh my god, running headbutt using that mohawk to her advantage here. As now, when sending her to the corner, tag to Evelyn. Evelyn, still the freshest of the two. Wait a minute. Oh my god. 3D! 3D! Go for the cover, but damn it. Mr. Ebayla's getting distracted by Ziva. God damn it. But that is not stopping Evelyn. Dropping the knee across the back of the neck, and now, ooh, missed the kick though. Now, wait a minute. Ooh, straitjacket German. Folded Evelyn up like a goddamn accordion. Jesus Christ. As now, wait a minute, Kizzy. Oh, it says pulled her by the hair. It says dropped her face first. As now, ooh, fine clothesline. Oh, Tommy Chalk. She ain't having no kids. Wait a minute. Oh my god, Zio's a fruit in the chair. And now, oh god. Tommy Two, she ain't having kids until a drop kick to the face. As now, oh god. Ooh. Quick kick to the gut and slap to the face. As now, oh! Ooh, that could have been some trouble. As now, Evelyn with the belly to belly. And you can see, if you didn't see there, folks, Ziva on the outside threw in that chair. And now, Mr. Vegas finally sees it. Taking out of play here in the middle of the ring. Honestly, that was smart. That was smart by the referee. And now, wait a minute. Kick to the gut, wait a minute, oh my god, no. No, we seen her do this multiple times last week. God damn, Verta Breaker. AKA the cop killer. One. Everybody gets one. Mystery Babies is now. Kick to the gut. Roxy is taking out, it's fighting Zora here, but wait a minute, Zora's coming back here. It's now, oh my god. Zora's bashing Roxy's head onto the top turnbuckle. Jesus Christ. All hell has broken loose. as now Zoro gets out of the ring, but ooh, arm drive there by Evelyn onto Kizzy. But Kizzy now quick hit the gut, doing it again as Roxy crawling her way back to up to Frame Buster! As now, ooh, stump. And now, women, look at this, Kizzy. Working on, oh god, missed the clothesline. She was trying to work on Roxy for a short minute, trying to get her out of play, but now Evelyn going to work, taking advantage of those very instincts of Evelyn coming into play here. As now, wait a minute. Ooh. So probably some miscommunication there by the human anomaly. Probably. Probably. Who's to say? Who's to say? No, I don't know. But now, ooh, kick to the gut. Wait a minute. Hammerlock DDT in the center of the ring, but that took a lot out of Evelyn. Just had to get the arm across to cover. One. Only gets a one. Zora broke up the pin. As now Roxy was trying to run interference, try to get Zora out of the ring, but couldn't get it. But now Evelyn, Big Lariat again. And a single leg drop kick. And now Evelyn trying to say this is done, but Kizzy reversing it and hits that clothesline in the corner. Got all of it as now just she's playing to the crowd. This is Jesus Christ, you crazy, crazy bitch. But wait a minute. Ooh, tripping the leg. Once again, Evelyn's very instincts coming into play. That's now sending her in the corner. Ooh, sidestep. Now, wait a minute. Kizzy sending her into the corner. Turn her around here. What are you looking for? Oh my god, snake eyes. God damn. And now, oh, Kizzy was trying to stop it, but Evelyn got the tag to Roxy, single leg dropkick. Oh, right hand. Dazed Kizzy for a little bit, but Kizzy coming back with that quick kick slap chop combo, but Roxy now coming back with, ooh, kick to the gut. And now, this is what Zora and Kizzy want. They want the numbers advantage here. They want to isolate the human outlet, which they have done for the majority of this matchup. And now, ooh, choking trip there by Kizzy. That's the thing that, like, they want to isolate and make sure to work on the opponent to make sure that they're weakened. That way they can get the win. So, and ooh, big running clothesline by Roxy. That day's store is just enough to make a road to the apron. Now, oh my god, 2-for-1 right hand. Jesus Christ. God damn. Roxy just gave them both a haymaker. I think Kizzy got the worst of that. She is out like a light in front of her friends with now team. Jesus Christ. And now the referee count. Remember, 20 count here and cast out. I'm hoping that this time we have a pinfall submission win. I'm hoping. I really am hoping. And now wait a minute, Sayu Super God damn. Literally, Roxy Mohawk is a threat to others and a threat to herself. And now, oh my god! The fuck you knee! The fuck you knee by Zora. Now sending Roxy into the corner, and now they're about to fucking stop on her shit. Jesus Christ, it's now Kizzy getting her licks in. Jesus Christ. Now Zora tagging herself back in, getting some more. Jesus Christ is stomping the shit out of Roxy. As now with a sliding drop kick in the corner. Jesus Christ. Now going straight for the cover here. One. Two. Only gets a two count. Zora's hanging in. Roxy's hanging in there. Oh, wait a minute. Caught the leg. As now grabbed her by the titty. As it slams her down. That is the first time I would ever say that. Ever. But wait a minute. Roxy now getting sent into the corner once again. But she kicks her way out of it. Right hand turns Kizzy around. But wait a minute. Reversal. Seriously, Roxy, she really needs to make a tag to Evelyn. as now we see the tag team cooperation between Zora and Kizzy once again. As now Zora front headlock here, but Roxy fighting out of it. Big right hand, right ahead, but she really needs to make a tag to Evelyn, and she does finally. Evelyn gets tagged back into this matchup, but gets caught with a jawbreaker immediately, but reversal with that knee. Now right to the eyes, and she ain't having no kids. I won't be an uncle to these bitches anyway. But once again, Ziva distracted Evelyn. And oh my god, once again with the German suplex. Jesus Christ. Headbutt, savat kick. Send Evelyn off the ropes. Single leg drop kick. Single leg drop kick again. Evelyn go for a clothesline, but get caught in a neck breaker in the center of the ring. Jesus Christ. Oh my, and now kick. Wait a minute. The fuck you knee. The fuck you knee. And she ain't done. Send her into the corner. Oh dear Christ. No. No. Oh god, no. You already hear the fans here in Raleigh, North Carolina. Superplex to the outside. Jesus Christ. Oh my god. Oh my god, and Evelyn is still, oh my god! The back of Zora's head hit the legs of the chair. But she's still fighting back that hard-ass head of hers. Coming into play, now these two going back and forth. Running STO by Zora, Jesus fucking Christ. God fucking damn. And now, wait a minute, Zora kicking her right in the chest. My god. And now, wait a minute. What's she looking for? Snap suplex! Mystery Paper's trying to tell these two to get their asses back in the ring. I don't blame you, sir. And now, Evelyn reversing out of that. Count of nine here. They are halfway through the count. There's the 10. They're officially halfway through the count. I'm really hoping not for another count out. Please don't do this to me again. It's now Zora sending Evelyn back into the ring. As now Wayne kick to the leg. The fuck you knee! The fuck you knee! Once again, she knocked down, but Evelyn kicks her off. She just went for the cover. That knee has been effective. As now Ziva distracted Evelyn once again. Mystery Babies, get her out of this damn match. God damn it. As now, Roxy trying to get in the ring, trying to do something, but once again, here we go, the drop toe, elbow to the lower back. And now, my sister's already in full control here, stomp to the back of the head. And now, oh my god, she's trying to gouge out Evelyn's eyes, oh dear god! Yeah, she was really trying to gouge out her eyes, my god, now, oh, went for a right, got hit with a forearm. Now, wait a minute, ooh, kick to the gut. Luthor's press, center of the ring, raining down the punches. Jesus Christ. Now going straight into the cover. One, two, only a two count. Kizzy, kind of seem tired there. That's something I rarely have seen in my life with her. Now, wait a minute. Oh, God, side effect. Yeah, Kizzy, she's getting tired out here. Normally, she doesn't. Guess she's being pushed to her limits, you could say. Big pull in lariat. And now, ooh, big boot by Evelyn. And once again, Ziva distracting the Himanali. Once again, Mystery Babas, get her out the damn ring. God damn. Or get her, eject her to the back. That's all I'm fucking saying. But wait a minute, what the fuck is this? Wait a minute, something new I have to play, but what the fuck is this across body? The fuck? The fuck? Yeah, there's something new to their playbook. And now, wait a minute. Zora has Evelyn up for the... Oh, God. Detonation kick. Oh, my God. Go for the cover. One, two. Only a two count. The human anomaly. They want to make a statement. They want to be at the front of the line. And a big running lariat got down. God fucking damn. Now, wait a minute. Gamzee has a hold of Evelyn as Zora finally gets back into the ring. As now, oh, probably some miscommunication there by Zora and Kizzy, but Kizzy's trying to fight Evelyn. And Evelyn sends Kizzy into the announce table. As now Zora has Evelyn. But ooh, elbows to the gut here by Evelyn, trying to fight out of this predicament. Clothesline, no. Big, oh my god! The back of Evelyn's head hit the chair. I keep forgetting about that damn chair, but Evelyn, she's been through worse and gets back into the full of it. Jesus Christ. Now, slamming her face first into the French announce table. And now, wait a minute. She does it again at the count of seven. Kick to the gut again. Wait a minute. What is Zora thinking here? What is Zora thinking? Oh my god, power bomb. And her back gave out. I think she was playing a power bomb Evelyn into the turnbuckle post. Reverse DDT though. Evelyn was looking for something but got caught with the reverse DDT, and now these two once again fight and get Anzorkis sent to the turnbuckle. Count of 11 here. As Evelyn sends Zora back in the ring, but Kizzy makes the tag. Big Lariat. Big Lariat again takes out Mr. Ebamus at the same time. No Lariat. Goddamn. Trifecta Lariat. Kizzy's going wild. As much as I hate to get crazy, and oh my god. Kizzy has Evelyn locked up again. The Cop Killer. And Mr. Ebamus finally gets to his feet. Going for the cover here. One. Two, only a two. If he probably got up sooner, that probably would be a three. But Kizzy top rope with a diving headbutt. This is already a phenomenal match. As much as I hate my sisters, they're doing some work here in this matchup. I cannot wait a minute. She having no kids. Once again. As now, Evelyn, wait a minute, ooh, pulls the arm through, wait a minute, dropped to a hold by Kizzy. As now, taking her into the apron, ooh, I mean the corner. My bad. As now, wait a minute, straight jacket, German suplex, go cover, one, two, three. The Terrax, aka my sisters, gets the win here tonight. And I think that has proven any doubt is wrong that they could not get the win in a meaningful fashion. And they just did it here in the opening of tonight's opening here tonight. God fucking damn. Hold up. God damn. I am out of breath for the most part, folks. But God damn. That was one crazy ass opener. As you can see, Zora joining her younger sisters in the ring. Your winners of tonight's opening contest, Kizzy and Zora the Terrax. God fucking damn. I almost thought I was gonna lose my fucking voice under that entire fucking match. God fucking damn it. What the fuck? Why did they want to go out and decide to pull out bangers? I don't fucking know. But we must move on tonight because we got more women's action here tonight. And so Veit Denhausen as introducing first JC Wright. It's been a while since we've seen her, folks. But one of the biggest and baddest women on the roster is making her way down to the ring. And now you're probably wondering, why did I say Veit Denhausen? Because here, Castell, if there's two big motherfuckers going in the ring against each other, and it's a hoss fight, we call a hoss fight a Veit Denhausen, because why the fuck not? Why the fuck not? But still, JC is still looking to make her name for herself here in Castell. And honestly, she can do it here tonight, because, like I said, here on Generations, we got the Valkyrie title picture, and got the IC television, which was cross promotional. And not only that, but soon I'm going to start, you know, qualifying matches for the Fight for Survival tournament pretty damn fucking soon. So, who knows? JC might be in the runnings for that tournament. Who knows? Who knows? I might even bring back another title from season one. Who fucking knows? But JC Fight here looking pumped up and ready for action here tonight, folks. And honestly, I can't wait to see it. And her opponent make her way down to ring now. She recently made her debut in a losing effort to Nova Kane. Ladies and gentlemen, Jacqueline Fletcher, the Ripper herself, another big bitch, big powerful bitch, here on the Castile's Women's Roster Series. So we have, like, let's see, there's Ivy Rose Patel, we got Jacqueline here, we got JC, we got Monstrosity, we got Paige of Earth, we got like five big bitches on this fucking roster, god fucking damn. And wait, should I count Roxy Apocalypse? Probably. Her mohawk is worth like 500 fucking pounds in of its fucking self. But still, fighting Allison here tonight, folks. Seriously, let me know who you want to win this match. Will it be JC? Will it be Jacqueline? Who fucking knows? Cause I sure as hell fucking don't. And honestly, folks, if you guys want this, and I might make a tweet about it after the show, but if you want to see Out Shows return, that way you can see more of your stars and see more of them get opportunities to wrestle, please let me know. I'll be happy to oblige. Because I honestly love the Out Shows. They can be fucking crazy sometimes. And trust me, it's a fucking, like, fucking, I can barely describe it. I fell asleep at one show once because it was so fucking late at night. I didn't fucking care. I just fucking did because your boy wanted to. Let's be honest. But JC Bright, Jacqueline Fletcher, look at the abs. And here we fucking go. Like I said, it's a fight that has us now. JC already with a straight jacket neck breaker off rip. And now, ooh, missed the kick to the back. And now, wait a minute. JC with the back elbow to the face, catching Jacqueline. As now, sending her into the corner pretty hard. Mayor comes straight out. As now, wait a minute. Dragon suplex. No! Jacqueline with the stunner, but barely stunned JC from what it seems. As now, wait a minute. Ooh! Reverse DDT. Reversed there by Jacqueline. Showing off the power that these two have. Wait a minute, row through schoolgirl. Wait a minute, one. Everybody gets one. What the fuck? It's now, wait a minute. Ooh, shooting the leg. Ooh, Tanahashi special. Ooh, that looks like it affected Jacqueline quite a bit. Quite a bit there. So now, ooh, big sharp forearm to the face. And now, club forearm to the back. Front headlock here. Jacqueline went for a cosign, but now, ooh. Ooh, kick to the legs. Yeah, Jacqueline knows that. I mean, JC knows that Jacqueline was holding her knee pretty well. It's now working on him. Now look at this, going for the cover. One. Everybody gets one again. But that's a smart strategy by JC. It's now, oh my god, that was a big fucking elbow. And she ain't ready to no elbow pass. That's pure blown fucking elbow. That's got to fucking hurt. It's now JC in full control here with the gator roll into the crossface. Jesus fucking Christ. JC is in full control of this matchup here in the early goings. My god. Jacqueline barely has time to get herself going, but she is now getting it with that reverse DDT. But once again, oh god. What a lariat. Dan Severn. Oh my god. But now JC once again in full control this matchup. Backbreaker final cut, whatever the fuck you want to call it, Anthony. Oh my god, JC's looking at Andy already. JC is looking at Andy already. Hammerlock DDT! God fucking damn, go for the cover. One, two, only a two count. Surprisingly, Jacqueline Flesh is showing that she has fight, folks. She wants to make sure that she doesn't go out early and beat 0-2 here in Casta. But oh my god! JC went high risk and didn't get nowhere where or is now Jacqueline Fletcher were OMYDT. We have seen like what fucking three on tonight's show so far? God fucking damn. Is now Jacqueline back elbow though. Now JC picks her up. What she's looking for here. Ooh, pop up cutter. God damn. I was not expecting that. It's now, oh god, sharp elbow to the back of the head. Going for the cover here. One. Everybody gets one. That is surprising. I'm surprised. That was just a one. But JC is now just stalking Jacqueline here. Jacqueline, like I said, she has barely got out of the gate so far in this matchup. She has barely has had any time to really get some momentum going her way. But wait a minute. As I say shit, nice enziguri there by Jacqueline. It's now from Headlock here. What she's doing, oh, with Struck. It's now return the favor from earlier, going after JC's legs now. Jackie, she's really trying to do something in this matchup here. Try to get some momentum. That's what she needs, but it seems like JC every time. Oh my! As soon as I was about to say shit, Jacqueline with that big boot, bicycle boot, and now sending these knees into the jaw. JC, god fucking damn! I can barely get a sentence out of my goddamn mouth without one of these ladies doing some shit that goes against what the fuck I was about to say. Jesus Christ! It's now Jacqueline. Once again now, coming back here, sending her into the corner. Shoulder block, no. Her shoulder first into the top turnbuckle. As now, oh god. Reversal after reversals, punch to the ribs. Send her off of the ropes. Ooh. I thought she was going to send hip toss Jackie out of the ring. I will not lie to you. I thought that was going to be some shit. As now, big power slam there. By JC has now went for a punch, but Jackie coming back, missed the punch though. Oh, Jackie went for a Superman punch, but Jackie's backstepped quite a bit. It's now, wait a minute, going back to the leg. Ooh, not Tanahashi special after the knee drop. Jacqueline Fisher is in a bad shape here once again. It seems like every time Jacqueline has tried to get the momentum on her side, JC, either in 1 or 2 minutes, shuts it down. But now, wait a minute. Oh, ladies and gentlemen, I think you need to buckle up your seatbelts. Make sure you're locked in tight because Jacqueline Fisher, all the way from the UK, going for a drive-by. Let me sip on this. And if you're wondering what I'm drinking Taco Bell Mandu. As, ooh, only a 2 for Jacqueline Fletcher. Yes, I ordered Taco Bell before the show. Don't blame me if I have to go to the bathroom. But only me 1 taco though. But JC now once again gets reversed by Jackie. But oh god, JC, like literally these ladies are trying to put on a clinic here. Reversal after reversal. Catching after catch is now. Oh! JC lower back gave out. And she was probably going to snake eyes Jacqueline onto the top rope here. Now Jacqueline getting some momentum, screaming in the face of JC. Now, ooh, punch to the face. But wait a minute, enziguri by Jacqueline. My fucking god! As now, these two fighting on the outside here. And they immediately get back in the ring. It wasn't even count. Referee barely had a chance to get the 2 count in. It's now Jacqueline going back to the legs of JC here. You gotta admit, I don't know how smart that is, considering that Jackie's legs have taken a considerable amount of damage. And oh god! Run knee to the face, center of the ring. One, two, only a two. As I was saying, I don't know how smart that was, considering that her legs have been took quite a amount of damage by JC with those dragon screw and leg smashes. I mean, she took an elbow to the knee not too long ago, but Jackie trying to catch her breath here, trying to slow down the pace just a little bit, as now wait a minute, kick to the gut, picking up JC Bright. Oh my god! One, two, three! Jacqueline Fletcher gets her first win in cat style. Congratulations. Jesus fucking Christ. I needed a drink of this Taco Bell Mountain Dew. Now folks, that is what I like to call top tier women's wrestling right there. Top tier women's fight in the house, and you can fight me all you want, say you have seen something like this similar in other shows. I would say otherwise. But there's your winner, the Ripper, Jacqueline Fletcher. Congratulations to Jackie. She earned it. She fucking earned it. You cannot lie, she fucking earned that win. You can't dispute it. You can't really dispute it. Honestly, but we must move on here tonight, because after last week's main event, making his way now to the ring, he requested a open mic here tonight to talk about what happened in the main event last week's show against Crimson. Ladies and gentlemen, make his way to the ring now. And some new gear. Look at the drip. Hold on. Drip check. Drip check for my man Nick Black here. The come on. Hold on. Drip check. Wait, is that a new tattoo, isn't it? What the fuck? But still, make his way to the ring. Nick Black. If you didn't see last week, he had an impressive showing against Crimson, but Crimson beat him, so Nick Black is looking to talk about it. So let's see what he has to say. And you heard him there from Nick Black. He wants a challenge here tonight and make his way to the ring, accepting the challenge. Hey, so wait a minute, can we get a drip check for my boy John Spyro? With the new look, everything, new tattoos, everything. Can we get a drip check? Drip check, drip check. And you heard it from Nick. He said he had basically a bad day last episode on episode 12 against Crimson. He said he's willing to And to quote Question and Andrew David and his new t-shirt, he can outwork anyone. John Spiro, who has been on a huge wave of momentum lately, getting some big wins after big wins. Looking to continue that in this. Honestly, this is a huge opportunity for the guy. Like, you cannot lie. John Spiro, he has been on, I would say, a big upward momentum here in Castile. It's just debuting, so. Let's. And he got a new theme. Hold on, I just peeped that. What the fuck? This man came out with new everything. God damn. This man came out with a new drip, new chat, new theme. What the fuck? But still, let's not focus on that, folks, as we got this matchup here. Nick Black, John Spiro. And already, John catching the leg and turning it into an STFU. What the fuck? But Nick Black, as much of a technician as he is, gets out of it quickly as now. Ooh! John with resemble got caught with a sling blade. As now, once again, John running at Nick, gets caught with a big suplex, flowing over into the pin, center of the ring. Mr. Babyface getting in position one. Everybody gets one. That could have been on two, my guy. That could have been two. That was a nice ass suplex. Now, ooh, big European uppercut. And now, oh, running European uppercut, but Nick Black, the sturdy motherfucker as he is, did not go down. It's now picking up, pulling him in with that big scoop slam. 200 islands almost. It's now, wait a minute, Nick, gut wrench suplex. Wait a minute, he ain't done. He's still hanging on. Wait a minute, roll through for another gut wrench suplex. Wait a minute, he's still hanging on. What the fuck? Pick him up once again for a trifecta. Gut wrench suplexes. God fuck damn. Kicked it back with John. Eat that shit like it was a bowl of cereal. But elbow to the knee by Nick. Now wait a minute. John catching Nick. Oh my god, weird barrel stutter. What the fuck? What the fuck? As now, John. Wait a minute. Ooh, big right hand by Nick. That stunned John a little bit. But John's still fighting back here, but a big back suplex by Nick. Wait a minute, he's still hanging on. Wait a minute. Another trifecta of back suplexes. What the? No. He doubled up the back suplex and just decided to dump John on his neck with a German suplex. But John, once again, go for you and Priya up a couple. What, like I said, Nick Black's a dirty motherfucker. Wait, blue thunder bombs! Have the ring, Jesus Christ. And now, Nick. Shots to the lower back and I've always said Nick Black was cocky, but this man, I didn't know he was that cocky, doing push-ups on your boy. As now, wait, oh my god, he's going back to it. More, he's going to triple it up once again. That count, make it, this a count of six. Gut wrench suplexes here. Can he get the final one? And he does another trifecta of gut wrench suplexes. But wait a minute, ooh, nice double leg takedown there by John. Nice double leg there. Now, oh, went for a slap, but Nick blocked it, caught him with a forearm. And now, ooh, John returned the favor with a forearm. Wait a minute, super kick delay, no. Side step there by Nick. And now, back suplex. He's looking to double up on this again. Another one. And another German suplex. Folding John Spiro up like an accordion. Now, ooh, what a quick left jab there by Nick. Now, wait a minute. Turn him around into the neck breaker. Wait a minute. He hanged on. Wait. Last chancery. But John gets out of it, punching Nick straight in the face. God fuck damn. It's now John dumping Nick Black out of the ring. Trying to probably catch himself a reader. He's been taking a lot of damage in this matchup. It's now, oh my god. I think, John's bleeding. I think that punch caught him pretty badly. And it's, oh my god, wait a minute. Hangman DT here by Nick Black. Oh my god. I guess he was having a bad day last week because he's in full control of this matchup. Like, for 90% of this matchup, Nick Black has been in full control here. He was having a bad day. He's proving it. Jesus Christ. But wait a minute. Ooh, tripping the leg. Getting up here, John. Sending Nick into the corner here. What could John Spiro be looking for? Has the arm, but ooh, Nick comes back with a forearm to the face. Ooh, high roundhouse kick. But Nick catching the other leg into the German suplex. And oh, I don't know what John was trying to hang on to the top rope, make sure he caught himself. I don't know, but wait a minute. Nick Black with the air raid crash on the knee. God fucking damn. And now, wait a minute. What's Nick Black looking for here? But, ooh, gets kicked in the gut. Nick alive. Forearm to the face. Punch to the face. Nick Black with a kick. Turning John around. Into the backbreaker. And that was nasty looking. Go for the cover. One, two. Only a two, and oh my god, I just noticed John's blood is on the hands of Nick Black here. He's literally, once again, doing these push-ups on the man's back. Like, Nick, forget it, you're cocky, you're trying to prove a point here, but Jesus Christ, man. And now, oh my god! High-angled German suplex by Nick Black. As now, yeah, you can see it on his right hand. The blood, John's blood. Wait a minute. Claymore kick! What the fuck? One, two, three. God damn! Nick Black. Statement made. Statement has been made. I feel sorry for John Spiro that he had to be on the receiving end of that, but statement has been made here by Nick Black. With blood on his hands. Folks, blood on his hands, and yeah, like I said, I feel sorry for John. I really do. Folks, that was a fantastic match. Once again, I feel bad for John. I was a Nick did him dirty in that match. I really do, but folks, it's time for a co-main event of the night. It's a street fight. Introducing first, Miami's finest, the icon, Cedric Young. And every time that beat drops, every fucking time that beat drops, something about it goes hard. But Cedric Young made his debut here on Generations. Won his match by distracting the referee with a steel chair and low blowing his opponent here tonight, DJ Young, when the referee had his back turned, and they had back and forth on Twitter about it. DJ saying that he wanted to give the new guy a shot, but now Hero Generations are going to go at it once again, but this time, no rules. It's a goddamn street fight, folks. Ladies and gentlemen, this is about crazy. But still, who you got in this match? Cedric Young or DJ? Because I honestly want to hear your beans. I honestly do. Because, excuse me. I got that Mountain Dew. Oh god. That Dr. Bell in me is acting up. I better make it for the entire rest of the fucking show. But make his way to the ring now. His opponent, DJ Young. Sorry about that, folks. I had to do that. Taco Bell, it came a calling. But we got this street fight here going, folks. Cedric Young, DJ Young, the Battle of the Youngs. Once again, going. Ooh, big knee there by DJ. Jesus Christ. It's now DJ Young dropping the knee against the back of the neck of Cedric now as he goes to the top rope here. Fly far. Oh, God, my neck. Oh, God, that hurt my neck. Oh, dear God, how he landed. Oh, God. And now Cedric Young taking full advantage after dodging that diving forearm. That's now, ooh, goes on out of the ring. That's now, wait a minute, DJ, I mean, but get, oh! Ooh, high knee there. This match already has honestly caught me off guard. Folks, first that landing by, oh my God, wait a minute. Ooh, butterfly suplex. Go for the cover. One. Everybody gets one. I mean, my neck is hurting due to how bad DJ landed on his neck. That shouldn't be possible. Oh! Cedric Young, I am now this cocky son of a bitch. This man is cocky at his finest. Palm bombs a man to the outside and then says poses. This man's cocky ass. Now, wait a minute. Ooh, shiny wizard there by DJ Young. Getting back into this matchup here as now. Says body slams him onto the apron. The hardest part of the ring, folks. The hardest part of the ring. As now, dropping a knee across the skull of Cedric. As now, forearm to the face here by Cedric. And now, big lariat. Cedric's coming back in this matchup here. Now, the disrespect. Putting his boot across the face of DJ is now as he pulls out a table. We're getting weapons and he's just throwing it at the. That running knee. That running knee. DJ's head hit the back of DJ's head hit the table. I can't speak. This is how crazy this match has been already. Going for the cover. Already one. Two. Only a two. If Mystery Babies went for the. Try to go. Help the pin sooner. That could have been a three there. Four and Cedric. But it doesn't seem like it's bothering. And he just blew him a kiss. That's probably him saying. This is it, buddy. But DJ coming back here with the complete shot jawbreaker kind of ordeal there. As now DJ just trying to get his bearings. Just letting Cedric crawl up to his feet. The no respect is shown here as now Cedric flying back. Getting to his feet, sends DJ off the ropes, drop kick, no, denied. Now, DJ was posing, but Cedric told him, good buddy, gave him a bicycle knee to the face. As now constantly stomping on his ass. As now, look at this, going after the legs of DJ Young here. Cedric really pulling on it too. Now picking him up. What is this? Wait a minute. Chip Starlight Special. DJ Young does not have no shining teeth. No more. It's now, big elbow drop there. And the confidence of Cedric is unbound. Go for the cover. One, two, only a two count. Cedric Young is looking good in this match so far. What is he looking for? Oh my God, there's that Shining Wizard again. He just jumped with it. He just jumped. One. Two. Only a two. That's what happened when you don't get no momentum. This man just jumped for it. This man had the vertical on point. He says, now good boy, go to sleep. Now wait a minute. Cedric, look at this. Tequila Sunrise. And he has that in deep. Jesus Christ. He has that in deep, folks. He has it in deep. Will DJ Young tap out? No, using his other arm to prop himself up just to kick Cedric in the face. But Cedric now back on the attack. Kick to the gut. What's this? Ooh! With some flavor on that body slam. And now, dropping the knee across the back of the head and neck of DJ Young. But DJ, with that European uppercut, going to bail again. But this I know, Cedric with the headbutt, punch to the face. It's now, wait a minute, DJ flipped out of it. Running knee, goddamn, bro's kneecaps for everybody. God, fuck, damn. And now back to the top rope here. Oh my god. I nearly died. I lost my breath there. Wait, ripcord cross knee count. God damn. He said, no, I don't need the sledgehammer. I'm just going to use my knee and knock this man out. But Cedric now, reversing. Jesus Christ. Ooh, right hand. And now jumping complete shot by DJ Young. Out of fucking nowhere, mate. Out of nowhere, going for the cover. Wait a minute. Oh, one, two, only a two. DJ using, oh my god. DJ using the knee to basically block that dropkick attempt. Using, all during that pinfall, using the ropes to try and get more leverage. Remember, anything goes. This is a street fight. Now, wait a minute. Oh! I think Sandra kicked DJ in the dick. DJ was looking for a hurricane run off the top, but Cedric, I think, literally kicked this man in the dick. But wait a minute, another shining wizard by DJ Young. My god, going for the cover. One, two, only a two. DJ Young, trying to think, what can he do? What can he do? And that, jawbreaker. By Cedric, but DJ pushing him away here. Running knee again, running Ross kneecap. And now, wait a minute. And the kind of vice here. And the kind of vice. Locked in the center of the ring. Cedric Young is in deep, deep trouble. But DJ just lets it go. And now, big shoulder block takedown. Cedric showing him why that was a bad idea. He could have kept it in deep. Bell clap. I mean, he had that in deep. He probably was losing the grip. That's probably why he let go. Which makes sense. Like, if you're losing your grip, you might as well let go. Now, wait a minute. Oh, dear God. Line him up again. Shining Wizard. Shining Wizard. The shiniest of wizards. That's how Cedric unloading, but DJ pushing him into the ring and now bringing the table back into play here. Wait a minute. DJ. Oh, God! On the table. With that reverse DDT. That's now Cedric is looking for something slowly. And the disrespect. Putting him on the table. One. Two. Only a two. Slapped him in the face. The ultimate form of disrespect is slapping a man in the face. Wait a minute. Tanahashi special. By DJ. Wait a minute. Schoolboy. Wait a minute. No. Super Geek Party. The cover. One. Two. Only a two. Goddamn. It's now. Wait a minute. Tripping the leg. The Cedric. And now, wait a minute, DJ with the jawbreaker. Jumping knee. Wait a minute, DJ going off of the ropes, dropping the knee across the face. And, yep, Cedric is busted open. That headband barely protected him. Now, knee of his own. Goddamn, these guys are throwing knees. I hope they'd have knee insurance. Yes, that was a Coney joke. I don't care. I laugh at myself. Now, dragon screw into the table. God damn. That's gotta hurt. It's now, dropping the knee across the head and neck again. Cedric, he's in bad shape here, folks. He's in bad shape. Kick to the gut. Oh my god. Set DJ Yo with the curb stop. Go for the pin. One, two, three. No! 2.9. Cedric Young with the 2.9 kick out. This ain't a pay-per-view, man. What the fuck are you doing? This ain't even the main event yet, folks. The man is after this. These two are just saying, no, let's have a banger before the main event. Like, what the fuck? Let's now aim it. Ooh, we're in power slam to the corner now. Oklahoma Stampede into the corner. He hit it in the center of the ring. And now, wait a minute. Shining Wizard! Seriously, these mans are busting out knees like Kenny Omega does with V-Triggers. I don't know how they do it. But these guys... these guys are doing it. I don't know how, folks. I don't know how. I seriously don't. And there it is. Shining Wizard. Center of the ring. One, two, another two count. What are these guys on? I don't know. What kind of shit these men are on, but it is working. It's now Cedric going after the knee of DJ here. Seriously, Cedric, he's trying to get this match done and over it. Wait a minute, Spring, what the... He's like, what the fuck? What? Now try to hit him with. Oh my god, I can't in this match. I fucking can't. Cedric, one, two. Cedric looks like he was cut open deeper from not only that injury, but those punches to the face by DJ. Jesus Christ, man. I can't even say shit. Big Lariat. Yep, DJ. Yeah, Cedric. Cedric's bleeding heavily. He's bleeding like a stuffed pig on Thanksgiving. Goddamn. Now Rick going after the eyes of DJ Young here with the hard cam edition, no doubt. Now wait a minute. Ship Skylark special. And that's him go for the pin instead. Looking to do some more damage by shots to the rip. Belly belly. No, this time Cedric. Tripping the leg, whatever DJ is going for with those belly to bellies. I don't know what he's going for. Wait a minute. Oh, tap for tap. Using the ropes. One, two, three. Cedric Young using the ropes for leverage to get the win in this hard fought street fight. My God. This was epic. This was a crazy ass match. I'm not gonna lie, this was crazy. Was I expecting it? Yes. Was I disappointed? No. Was I almost on the verge of having a stroke? Yes, but ladies and gentlemen, there's your winner. Miami's finest, Cedric Young.
So hand me the money, I divvy the pie. I'ma give all of my people a portion to build them a fortune. I'm flipping the ride. I can't be mixing with iffy the vibe. And 40 on 50 is really the time. Why is you all on my phone like you want me? Like you wasn't pushing the kids to the side. I don't know if you bitches.
Ooh boy, I wish I had time to recover, folks. But ladies and gentlemen, it's time for our main event of the evening. It is for the Castile Deathweight Championship. And remember, folks, this is a open challenge. So let's see who will be challenging Victor Escobar for his death weight. Oh! Well, we don't have to wait. Let's get straight into it. Ladies and gentlemen, Morgan Richards is accepting the open challenge. This man I've said it time and time again, a underrated top talent. Former Castile Ultra Vault champion. This man wants more gold here in Castile. And I can't even blame him. This man has been trying to fight for his spot here in Castile for the longest time. But he gets an opportunity to go for gold here, or whatever the Deathwish title is made of. I literally commissioned it to tell the guy who's made the title to just get whatever medals you can find out of a trash can. But still, Morgan Richards, this is a big opportunity for him. And in the main event of Generations Episode 13 here tonight, as we get closer and closer to New Revolutions, folks. Honestly, it's crazy. But making his way to the ring now, the Deathweight Champion himself, Victor Escobar. This man won the title away from Matthew Black at Cyber New Year, and he told me that he wants to defend it. He didn't care if it was at pay-per-view or at a regular generation show. He wants to defend the title. He wants to show why the Deathweight division is the craziest division in Castile. I mean, if you saw the street fight that happened before this match, yeah, there are some guys who aren't afraid of going through the extreme here in Castile. Okay? And you could say that the king, all of them crazy motherfuckers, is that man right there, Victor Escobar. Also, I can't wait for this match. Remember, hardcore rules. This is false kind of anywhere, free five rules. Let's see. As you see there, the Deathweight Championship. Like I said, the guy who met it, he literally told me he got Sheva metal out of trash can. But time for official in-ring interest as a challenger for Capstyle Ultra Vault Champion. And I'll keep saying it again and again. One of the most underrated talents, ladies and gentlemen, Morgan Richards. And his opponent, he's the current reigning and defending the second holder of the Capstyle Deathweight Championship, the silencer himself, Victor Escobar. There he is, folks. And then off to the referee. Will tonight be a one and done here for Victor? Is Morgan Richards going to walk away with his second ever title in Castile Wrestling? Who knows for sure? Certainly I don't. But Morgan looks ready. Victor looks ready. Referee, win that damn battle. And here we go. Main event time, folks. And Morgan Richards already showing the power that he has. But Victor ain't having it as now. And I like this contrast of styles, you could say, between Morgan and Victor. Victor, a deathmatch specialist. Morgan, a wrestling practitioner, if you will. And the contrast of styles here is kind of crazy. That's now, ooh, hammerlock back suplex by Victor. And you can see already we just starting off with wrestling, just trying to like start this match out high, and that's what these guys want to do. These two are big dudes, and ooh, seriously, I mean, after the last match, I don't want to see no more knees. I don't know how these people be doing it. Even I ain't got knees like that. And with the cap up, this man swagging. My God. But Victor now. Hammerlock again for that back suplex. That's his name, Morgan. You want to take out the power in his arms, but because this man is so athletic, you might as well go for his legs. Because that man can pull off moonsaults, drop kicks, whatever, hurricane runs, whatever you name it, he can probably do it. And now, ooh, big back elbow there by Victor, by the champ, is now following up with a drop kick to the back of the head. Jesus Christ. Now, ooh, showing some submissions here. already with that armbar, but Morgan Richards punching him dead in the face. Oh man, that was just dead. That was dead pain in the face. There's no way to put it in. Ooh, big splash in the corner. There's just no way of describing it. Morgan Richards just punching him dead in the face to get out of there. It's now, wait a minute, going into the audience to catch his breath. I don't know how smart that is, but the fans in attendance getting a front row seat to the action. As now Victor going to the crowd himself, and he gets punched out of the crowd. Wow. Now Morgan hopping the barricade again, and then he goes back over the barricade. Jesus Christ, and now here comes Victor. Fouling the audience again, he goes over the barricade again. Back and forth, back and forth, back and forth. Here we go again. No, knife edge chop back. We thought, yeah. Wait a minute. What? Oh my god, wait, if you track DT. No! Morgan flipped through. Like I said, Morgan Richards, he is athletic. Now, wait a minute. Ooh, missed a distance punch. And now, ooh, high angle German suplex. Wait a minute, count on the outside. One. Everybody gets one. Whenever folks falls, count anywhere rules. Apply here, drop kick to the knee. Goddamn. And now Victor, for some, but ooh, slapping the hand, Morgan's outfit, but gets caught with the jawbreaker. Back chop, drop kick. Victor showing off some lyricism himself. Goddamn. Now throw him into the ring here. Now, what does the champ have in store for his challenger? Waist lock here into the German suplex. God damn. That was a high angle, but it was still effective. Dropping the man on his neck. But, ooh, forearm to the back by Morgan. Missed the punch, though. Missed the follow-up, but now... Victor. Once again, waist lock. This time into a reverse DDT. Stomp to the face. As now... ooh! Ramming the knees into the face. Jesus Christ. Jesus Christ Almighty. Isn't that Victor? What's he looking for here? Nothing. Morgan said, oh my god. Kick to the gut. Sending Victor into the corner. Splash, no. Back elbow. And now, ooh. I don't know what Victor was going for there, but it kind of backfired. As now, wait a minute. Belly to belly. Probably, honestly thought Victor reversed it, but Morgan got it. One. Everybody gets one. I think Victor was trying to put his weight down, but as strong as Morgan Richards is, he said, nuh-uh, good buddy, we're going for a ride. Now jump complete shot there by Victor. Try to get some momentum back in his favor of Mr. Stomp, though. Wait a minute, punch to the face. Punch to the face again. Send him off to rope. Wait a minute. Morgan reverses, but wait, and he stuffed it, dude. That was almost like a shoot knee. Going back to the armbar here, they haven't used weapons at all in this matchup. I am very surprised, honestly. I think they just wanted to fight. Let's be honest. They just wanted to fight. Wait a minute, Morgan. No, Victor with the elbows to the jaw. I almost saw Mark was looking to end the matchup here. And now once again with the reverse DDT by Victor. Seriously, I thought Mark was going to try end it. But wait a minute. Future Shock DDT by the champ. Go for the cover. One. Two. Only a two count. Victor can't believe it. Honestly, you're going to need to do more than that, buddy. This man has been through an Iron Man match before on the Grand Stage Castile has to offer. Now, wait a minute. Cutter. No. Morgan. Wait a minute. Got her. He didn't get it the first time. Check the time to strike. One, two, three. Victor Escobar is still your Castile Death Weight Champion. No weapons needed. They just won the fight. That's all I can say. That was honestly after the craziness of the straight fight between the Youngs, this match was like, you know what? They didn't need weapons. They wanted to fight. They wanted a fist fight, and they just got like it was just two like, this is the end of the match right there. Went for the cutter, then came back in and got it. Ladies and gentlemen, I will say once again, the winner of this match, and still your Castile Deathweight Champion, Victor Escobar. Folks, I have been Matt Rush, and I will see you all next time.